Hello students, welcome to JCE Connect channel. Today we'll study chopper. Chopper means a DC to DC converter. Today we'll study the chopper. Chopper is also called as the DC to DC converter. Now we will begin with the chopper classification. In the chopper classification, how the chopper is classified? According to the input and output, they are classified as step up chopper or step down chopper. Step up chopper means output voltage is greater than the input voltage. DC output voltage is more than the DC input voltage. Step down chopper means output voltage is less than the input voltage. Now, according to the direction of output voltage and current, chopper is classified as class A, class B chopper, class C, class D, and then class E chopper. Depending upon whether the output voltage is positive or negative, they are classified as class A to class E chopper. According to the circuit operation, their chopper is classified as first quadrant or two quadrant or four quadrant. First quadrant means what? First quadrant means what? Here the output voltage and current will be positive. Or we'll say class A. Here class A chopper. In the first quadrant, according to the circuit operation, we'll say that the first quadrant chopper. First quadrant chopper means what? Output voltage is also positive, output current is also positive. Two quadrant chopper means what? Output voltage is positive, current can be positive or negative. Or we'll say output current is positive and voltage can be positive or negative. Say class D or class C. Here we'll be having class C or class D. How the class C and class D will be? In class C, output voltage will be positive, current can be positive or negative. In class D, how we'll say output voltage can be positive or negative, but the current will be positive. This is class C and then class D, two quadrant operation. In the first quadrant, both output voltage and current are positive. In this two quadrant, the output voltage is positive, current can be positive or negative. Here, the output voltage can be positive or negative, current is positive. In fourth quadrant means class E. What will happen in the class E chopper? This is the class E chopper, where the voltage can be positive or negative, or current can be positive or negative. Output voltage can be positive or negative, or the current can be positive or negative. According to the commutation method also, choppers are classified as voltage commutated chopper, current commutated chopper, load commutated chopper, impulse commutated chopper. What is the meaning of commutation? Commutation is method of turning of the SCR. So in this, depending upon whether the voltage is used for the communication, current is used, or the load is used, impulse commutated chopper. In this way, the choppers are classified. Now, we'll next take the step down chopper. Next, we'll take the step down chopper. We'll see. We have seen now what is step down chopper. In the step down chopper, output voltage is less than the input voltage. This is the basic operation. This is the basic principle of step down. Output voltage is smaller than the input voltage. Now here in the step down chopper, the SCR can be used as a chopper. Here I can use the SCR or silicon control rectifier or the power BJT or the power MOSFET. Here this S can be, this switch can be SCR or BJT or power MOSFET. In the step down chopper, the output voltage is smaller than the input voltage. When the S is conducting, when this is on, when I make this switch closed, the path of the current is the EDC plus, path of the current is EDC plus, switch is closed, inductor, load, and then EDC minus. This is the path of the current where inductor stores the energy. When the switch is open, energy stored in the inductor is released through the freewheeling diode. This is the path. I'll repeat once again. When the switch is closed, when the switch is closed, the path of the current is from EDC plus, switch, inductor, load, and then EDC minus. During this period, inductor stores the energy. When the switch is open, stored energy will be released through the freewheeling diode. This is the path, EDC load diode, EDC load diode. So during T on, inductor stores the energy. During T off means when this is open, stored energy will be released. Again during T on, inductor stores the energy. During T off, energy stored is released. Here this is DF. DF is the freewheeling diode. And here the output voltage is given as E0 is equals to EDC into T on by T on plus T off. Means now this E0 is directly proportional to this T on. If the on period is more, if this on period is more, output voltage is varied. It is more. More means what? It will not be more than the input voltage. Because see, we have here T on plus T off as T. This is what T. So these two are proportional. If you want output voltage to be increased little, then T on will be increased. But the output voltage will be smaller than the input voltage. This is a basic principle. Output voltage will be smaller than the input. If you want little more the, as the output, smaller than input, but a little more if you want, then on period can be increased. Then see T on by T on plus T off. T on plus T off is T. 1 upon T is frequency. So E0 is EDC into F upon F into T on. This is the average load voltage. Load current is given as EDC upon R into alpha. If you want to calculate the RMS value, it is given by root of EDC square into T on by T on plus T off. T on by T on plus T off can be denoted as alpha. This is the step down chopper. Next we'll go with the step up chopper. Step up chopper means what again? The basic principle is what? Here in the step up chopper, basic is output voltage is more than the input voltage. In the previous it was output voltage is smaller. So it is called as step up DC. This is chopper means DC to DC conversion. Output voltage is more than the input. Now how the circuit operation here is? When the switch, yes, chopper, can be a SCR or power BJT or power MOSFET. I can choose it as SCR or I can select a BJT or I can select a power MOSFET, power BJT or a SCR. When the switch is closed, path of the current is from here, path of the current is EDC plus, inductor, switch or the chopper and then EDC minus. During this time, the inductor stores the energy. When this chopper is open, energy stored in the inductor is released through the freewheeling diode. Path of the current is plus supply, inductor, diode. Energy stored in the inductor is released now. Freewheeling diode, load, and minus supply. Again, this path, the energy stored in the inductor is released. So, during the on period, energy stored in the inductor is EDC into IS into T on. During T off, energy released by the inductor is E0 minus EDC into IS into T off. We'll see, we'll take the system as lossless. Then energy stored is equals to energy released. So WI is equals to W0. So energy stored is EDC into IS upon T on. Energy released, during the off period of the chopper is E naught into EDC, E naught minus EDC into IS upon T off. Equate them and simplify for output voltage. And simplify for the output voltage. So if I want this output voltage, then I'll take E naught minus EDC as here. Then this IS and this IS goes. Then EDC into T on upon T off. I want output voltage, so I will send this EDC on this side. So EDC plus EDC into T on by T off. EDC if I'll take common, 1 plus T on by T off. Take the LCM as T off, T on plus T off by T off. T on plus T off is T upon T off. T off can be taken as T minus, T off can be taken as T minus T on, because T on plus T off is T. Here I'll divide the numerator and denominator by T. So the numerator becomes 1. Here also 1 minus T on by T. T on by T is alpha. When alpha is 0, when I take this alpha as 0, 1 by 1 minus 0. So this becomes 1. It is E naught equal to EDC. When alpha is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, 1 upon 0 is infinity. So output voltage is infinity. So next we'll go for step up down chopper. It is both step up and step down chopper. When this chopper, again the same principle here also, this chopper can be a SCR, this chopper can be a SCR, power BJT or power MOSFET. When the here chopper is closed, the inductor stores the energy, and the chopper is closed during T on, inductor stores the energy. So energy stored is EDC into IS, IS is this current, into T on. During T off, energy stored in the inductor is released. Energy stored in the inductor is released through the freewheeling diode. It is released through freewheeling diode. The energy released is E naught into IS upon T off. We'll assume this is lossless. We'll consider the system as lossless. So energy stored is equals to energy released. Energy stored is equals to energy released. So we'll equate them. EDC into IS into T on is equals to E naught IS T off. I want output voltage. So this IS IS goes. So E naught is equals to EDC by into T on by T off. T off can be written as T minus T on. So EDC into 1 upon, we'll be taking here common as T on. I'll divide the numerator or the denominator by T on. So we have 1. T on by T on becomes 1 by T on minus 1. T by T on actually is 1 upon alpha. So EDC is equals to now alpha by 1 minus alpha. When the alpha is between 0 to 0.5, if I substitute here, it becomes step down. If I substitute alpha in the range 0.1 to 0.5 to 1, it is step up. So today we studied classification of chopper, step up chopper, step down chopper, and step up as well as step down chopper.